We brought educators together to discuss their experiences with implementing assistive technologies in the classroom. In this segment, they're talking about discovery, assessment, and planning.
I'd like to know, first of all, would you mind sharing with us how you first discovered the need of assistive technology for a specific student in your school setting?
First, we have either a clinician, such as a psychologist, speech and language, occupational therapist, or it could have been a teacher, staff member, a parent come forth to suggest that is that beneficial for a student to have assistive technology. And so at that point, we meet as a school team, and we determine the appropriateness, if it's time, what equipment is needed, and we go from there.
How do you as a team decide what technology is the best fit for that student?
A number of students don't have a psych report to identify or let us know what are the specific tools that they would benefit from using. So again, through the direct involvement with that student, working with them and assessing where they're at and what are the required tools based on that student's strengths and needs, then we're able to identify what are the appropriate tools and what are the requirements for that child, involving as well the student in the goal setting process around these are the tools that I do require, this is how it will help me, and this is what I need to do.
After the initial provision of assistive technology, the student's needs will change over time, and I think there needs to be that sort of continued assessment and look at what the needs are, and you know, based on when a new software applications are available, and add those accordingly. I don't think it's their assessment is done and then it's over. It needs to be done as the student grows, matures, and maybe goes from say a junior level into intermediate and on to senior.
You have a student coming to your classroom and you find out that this child is coming in with assistive technology. This child may have had former training or not. How do you as a teacher plan for this, with this child in mind?
We have the resource teacher working with the students outside of the classroom a little bit first to prepare them. And then we go in and we help, you know, with the teacher and with the students set up the best location, where to put the scanners, where we're going to put the printers, to make sure the outlets are available. It's all very new at the elementary school level for them, and so they're very nervous. And so we are pre-planning before all of this happens. At that point, we address the class and talk to them about, we're having some laptops come into the classroom, and we try to explain to them why. It's certainly assistive technology, it is benefits everyone, but it's essential for some. And so we really like to talk to the class so that, you know, they understand why they get laptops and others do not.
As a special education teacher teaching a congregated class, most of the students have assistive technology, but not all. And in planning my instruction, I need to think in a way to meet their needs. So whether or not it's a soft copy or a copy on a thumb drive or USB stick versus a worksheet, and adjust accordingly. They may have had initial instruction by a technology trainer or what have you, but I think that's just the beginning, not the end. As an instructor or a teacher, I need to make sure that not only just know how to use the application, but also how to use it to actually learn.
Also, it's really important for a classroom teacher, as she's giving the instructions, to also remind students it's time to take out your laptop. We're going to be scanning in this worksheet. The students really, really need someone over their shoulder in the beginning stages. And it's a constant reminder, always take out your textbook, make sure your laptop's open. It's
Thanks for watching. You may wish to look at the other videos in this series and browse through the resources available on our website.